मीनिंग ऑफ चरण विधि। देन इट सेज सर्वे कल्याणमूर्ति समकितधारी महात्माओना शुद्धात्मा ने अत्यंत भक्ति थी अभेद भावे वारंवार त्रिकाल नमस्कार 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 करी एटलू मागू छू के समता भावे मैं जे दृढ़ निर्णय निश्चय कर्यो छे कि मने शुद्धात्मा अनुभव प्राप्त थाओ अने ते प्राप्त थवामां सर्वे कल्याणमूर्ति समकितधारी महात्माओना सर्वोत्कृष्ट सद्गुणों मारा मा उत्कृष्टपणे स्फुरायमान थई मने शक्तिवंत बनावो शक्तिवंत बनावो शक्तिवंत बनावो। विथ अटमोस्ट डिवोशन एंड वननेस आई रिपीटेडली ऑफर माय ओबेसांस थ्रू आउट टाइम द पास्ट प्रेजेंट एंड फ्यूचर टू द प्योर सोल ऑफ ऑल सेल्फ रियलाइज्ड महात्मास हु आर द एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ सेल्वेशन। ऑल आई आस्क फॉर इज दैट आई अटेन द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ द प्योर सोल फॉर विच विद इक्वानिमिटी आई हैव मेड एन अनफ्लिंचिंग डिसीजन एंड डिटर्मिनेशन। And in attainment of that, may all the highest virtues of all self-realized Mahatmas, who are the embodiment of salvation, arise within me and fill me with energy, fill me with energy, fill me with energy. What this is asking is that however much experience has come forth and virtues that have manifested in Mahatmas, may I attain all of them and attain complete experience. May all those virtues manifest in me and may I attain the complete experience of the Self. So from every angle, say there's a diamond. How many facets does it have? So if Dada is the complete diamond, then one person has recognized him in one way, a second person in another way, someone else has recognized him in a third way. Everyone has become stuck or attached to Dada through some experience or another. So that is at the gross level, and at the subtle level, everyone has gotten a taste of the Self at some level. So, to whatever degree they have gotten the experience, may I attain all of that. That is the expressed intent or bhavana in this. So it says, may all the highest virtues of all self-realized Mahatmas, who are the embodiment of salvation, arise within me and fill me with energy. And if I always see any virtue in you, such as, oh, how well she remains in Gnan, how much awareness he maintains. If I appreciate you in this way, if I praise that virtue, then that virtue will manifest in me. But if I say, he's been coming for 10 years, so he's bound to have some awareness, if I will do samayak every day, then my awareness will also increase. So, if even the slightest competition arises, if the intent of competition arises, then veils form over the awakened awareness or jagruti. So we should always look for virtues in others. They have stuck to Dada, have they not? And certainly some good virtues have manifested in them. The faults of the Prakriti or the relative self will exist in the person. But see the positives, and these positives refer to any good attributes, attributes of Gnan. They have grasped Gnan in one way or another. They have grasped some understanding of Gnan. If we appreciate that understanding, if we express our awe towards that understanding, then the attribute of that understanding will manifest in us. So this is a very subtle point. We have this expressed intent or bhavana, but the causes should be nurtured in this way by deciding, I don't ever want to see the negatives of anyone. I want to see only the positives, and actually even beyond positives. Seeing positives is considered auspicious or shubh. This is going beyond even positives. That he has devotion towards Dada, he has indeed held on to some gnan, and he must be remaining in some gnan. He wants to attain final liberation or moksha. He wants to settle files with equanimity. So he definitely has acquired some experience. Many acquire the experience during one occasion or another. One may say, oh, such and such happened to me, and at that time, Dada's gnan remained present and awareness remained, equanimity remained. That is considered manifestation of gnan. In the same way, something or another has manifested in everyone. May I attain that? That is the expressed intent or bhavana that we are having here. Then it says, Samasta Vishwanu kalyan karo, kalyan karo, kalyan karo, ane kalyan karvani mane param shakti apo. Grant salvation, grant salvation, grant salvation to the entire universe, and grant me the absolute energy to serve this salvation. Salvation here refers only to salvation of the self or Atma Kalyan. The other salvation, that of society and families is a different matter altogether. Salvation of the self refers to attainment of knowledge of the self. It is for this purpose that we pull people to come to satsang, give out books, so that they acquire some understanding of jnana. And ultimately, it is when they take jnana that the salvation of the self begins. The salvation of the self begins from the moment one acquires the knowledge of separation. Nevertheless, if everyone is not able to attain jnana, then our expressed intent or bhavana is what Dada says. May others attain the happiness that I have attained. This is a very exalted intent or bhavana. So the intent for the world's salvation begins from this point. The intent that I experience some peace here, so may those who encounter me also attain some peace. From the moment this positive expressed intent or sadbhavana arises, one will definitely progress on the path to salvation. Samasta vishvana jivo sukh ane shanti ne pamo. May all the living beings in the universe attain happiness and peace. Inherent in this is the second part, that may there be salvation of the self. Many living beings will acquire self-realization, salvation of the self, and attain final liberation. And the remaining living beings who are unable to attain this, may they attain happiness and peace. That too is incorporated in the expressed intent or bhavana. And the rule is such that to have the intent of salvation for others, that in itself will make one the embodiment of salvation or kalyana swarup. That will take one towards the completion of becoming the embodiment of salvation. And what is the other rule? However much salvation one has attained, he will be able to serve for the salvation of others. And there's no doing in salvation. When you become the embodiment of salvation, others will acquire their own salvation by seeing you. That is the rule. That is the ultimate point. When you become free from attachment, abhorrence, anger, pride, deceit, greed, obstinacy, all forms of pride, ego, when you become free from all that, you become the embodiment of salvation or kalyana swarup. And however much you become the embodiment of salvation, people will begin to become that form just by looking at you. Dada was one sample of this. Today, so many have become so, haven't they? They have progressed incrementally. And what is the embodiment of salvation? First, one should become an idol of faith. Upon just seeing, the faith will set in for people that this is where I will attain salvation. I will be set free. That is called an idol of faith. How does one become so? As we abide by the five principles or agnas, as the discharge, anger, pride, deceit, greed get finished off, we will become that form. And thereafter, nature itself will make you the instrument of world salvation. You don't need to go out and work towards world salvation. It is not even the matter of having the ego of working towards world salvation. Keep on nurturing the inner intent of world salvation. The result of that will be that nature will bring together everyone, and just by hearing a few words, changes will take place within them. This will make you an instrument of world salvation.
He Vishwavandya eva pragat shuddhatma swarup prabhu, hu kadi pan aap gurudev thaki.
O Lord, who is worthy of being universally revered, who is the manifest form of the pure soul, may I never through you, my respected spiritual teacher or guru. Here the word Gurudev or respected spiritual teacher is written. However, Dada says that, while you may accept us to be so, we will not accept it. This is because we remain as an instrument or nimit, but you should consider us as your everything or sarvasva. The Jnani is my everything. He is my Atma or Self. However much obligation you feel, if you believe him to be your everything, then Jnana will have result within you. But if you say he says that he is just an instrument, he himself is saying he is just an instrument. So he is just an instrument, and I have attained what is mine anyway. Then the interim stage of Jnana will disappear. So you should accept him as your complete everything. Dada further says, if I were to say I am your everything, I have given you so much, then your Jnana will decline and so will mine. So we remain as an instrument or nimit and say, you have acquired this Jnana due to your merit karma, but believe the Jnani to be your everything. So the word Gurudev is written here. So for us, he is our everything.
venerable, but he himself does not become a guru, nor does he make anyone his disciple. He says, I remain in the self or atma. We place you in the self. So which atma is whose guru and which atma is whose disciple? Nevertheless, this is placed in worldly terms. Then it says, Jnanavadati syadvadati param jnanti param dhyanti. Towards acceptance of knowledge of the self, acceptance of all viewpoints, absolute knowledge, internal state that renders the constant awareness of I am pure soul, so that knowledge which is related to the self is considered Jnanvad. Then we hurt no one in worldly interaction. Just as in all the functional properties of the self, there should be no opposing action that arises. Then Syadvad means that there should be no such thing as Muslims are like this and Hindus are like this. The foundation of any religion, of any ego, should not be hurt. Such as thieves are like this and robbers are like this. But no, that is their ego. Why should we hurt their ego? To steal is their dharma, their property. Why should we speak negatively? They are taking out a loan from the bank. They will have to pay it back with interest one day. And someone who is making a donation is making a deposit in the bank, which he will enjoy with interest. Everyone should mind his own business. If we speak negatively, then we become liable. So we are saying, Jnanavadati, Syadvadati, Param Jnanti, Param Dhyanti. So Keval Jnan means Param Jnan, or absolute knowledge. Param Dhyan means Shukla Dhyan, or internal state that renders the constant awareness of I am pure soul. So it talks about that, and beyond that, it talks about all the phases by which may I not make a mistake. First towards you, my Gurudev, then towards discussion about knowledge or Jnanvad, towards acceptance of all viewpoints or Syadvad, towards absolute knowledge or Param Jnan, towards the internal state that renders the constant awareness of I am pure soul or Param Dhyan. Then it says, Shuddhatmati, Shuddhatmani Upasana Karnara Sarve Kalyanmurti Samkittari Mahatmauna Shuddhatmati Sarve Siddhoti Santoti Mahantoti Jagatna Jeev Matrati. Towards all pure souls of self-realized Mahatmas, who are the embodiment of salvation and devoted to the pure soul, all liberated souls, all saints, religious leaders, all living beings of this world. Just look, nothing has been left out. Everything is included. It says, may I never be doubtful or shankit towards anyone. What does shankit mean? It means to doubt. Vanchit means to cheat. Shankit means to have doubts, whether it is about your jnan or yourself, the jnani, or mahatmas, or whether the Siddha Bhagavan or absolutely liberated lords actually exist or not. One may say, is this kind of moksha possible? Or how is moksha possible? Do not have those type of doubts. So it says, may I never be doubtful. Vanchit means, I will never cheat. To slack off is the same as cheating. Then what does bado mean? Bado means to give the appearance of looking in one direction, but really one is looking in another direction. That is drashti dosh, or to view with the wrong intent. That is considered overt or gross level waywardness. And this is saying, may I never be wayward towards jnan. Bado means, may I never have the wrong understanding of jnan. May I never misunderstand what you are trying to tell me. It says, may I never become wayward in terms of jnan. Devi shakti bhakti drashti jnan vivek vinay charitra ane prajnapo. Grant me such energy, devotion, perspective, knowledge, discrimination, humility, conduct, and wisdom. In every way, with all of these virtues, may such mistakes not happen. And may I never do any of this to anyone. May I never have doubts about anyone. May I never cheat anyone. May I never cheat even Mahatmas. May I never cheat even the Jnani. Yes, if you go slightly out of line, it is the equivalent of cheating the Jnani. The slightest association with anyone other than your spouse, drinking alcohol, eating meat, all of that is walking in the opposite direction from what the Jnani tells us. So, it is the equivalent of cheating the Jnani. If you appear to be sensible here in satsang, yet elsewhere you are engaging in misconduct, then that is a grave betrayal. So we are saying, may I never do any of that. It is due to mistakes like these that we have wandered for infinite lives. Just once, if one misses out on submission to the Jnani and goes according to one's self-guided whim or swachand, then one will go off track, leading to decline or wandering. One may say, what problem do I have? I have already become the self or atma. With the slightest doubt or fearlessness, when a mistake is committed, one falls. So we are asking for the energy so that none of this happens. Ek nishtha purva keval ek apnij agnya maj vartvani mari je drad abhilasha che ane pratignya che te puri karvani shaktiyo mane prapt thao prapt thao prapt thao. May I attain the energies to fulfill my ardent desire and solemn pledge to prevail only within your agnyas with complete sincerity. Nishtha means sincerity, without slacking off. It says to prevail only within your directives or agnya. If you have to abide by the wife's directives in worldly interaction, then so be it. What else can you do? But truly speaking, I want to abide by only your agnyas or directives. From within, I am pure soul. Baldev Bhai has to abide by the directives of those in the office, at home, the children. All of that goes under Baldev Bhai's account. Do not keep it in your account. We have only one aim, and that is to prevail in Dada's five agnas that have been given. Once the determination or nischay has been made to abide by them, then one will abide by them. That is considered to prevail in them. My ardent desire and solemn pledge to prevail. So there is only this ardent desire, or jankhana. Only this desire. This is my complete ardent desire, or sampurna abhilasha. So this is my everything. This is all I ask for. And pratigna means, for example, one will say, I am making the firm resolve. I am taking a solemn pledge. That is pratigna. The solemn pledge to abide by the agnyas. So it says, give me the energies to fulfill my ardent desire to abide by the agnas. May these energies arise within me, arise within me, arise within me. Aaj din ni adhyakshan paryant aapni je koi agnya marathi pali shakai nathi te sarvani hu kshama magu chu alochana pratikraman pratyakhyan karu chu mane kshama karo kshama karo kshama karo. I ask for your forgiveness for not being able to abide by your agnyas all the way up until the last fraction of this moment. I confess, ask for forgiveness, and resolve to never make these mistakes again. Please forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. We do say this here, but some days, sit for 15 minutes or half an hour or so at night and check where you were not able to abide by the agnyas. Where did you miss out on being in the agnyas? Examine this and then repent for it and make a firm resolve or nischay that starting tomorrow, I want to remain in the agnyas in exactness. I am asking for forgiveness for missing out on this. Please forgive me and give me the energy to not make such mistakes again.
He Vishwavandya eva pragat shuddhatma swarup prabhu. Aapno bodhelo satsang marama nirantar thao, nirantar thao, nirantar thao.
O Lord, who is the manifest form of the pure soul, who is worthy of being universally revered, may the satsang that you have imparted always continue on within me. Bodh means satsang or discourse about the self. That satsang you have imparted, the science of separation between the self and the non-self that has been acquired, the understanding that you give me to remain still in the self, may that always continue in me, may it resonate in me. May it be present time after time, so that I may never err, and moreover, may it make me still in the state of the pure soul. May such satsang that you have imparted always continue on within me.
Apnu bodhelu samyak jnan mane kshane kshane jagruti arpo, jagruti arpo, jagruti arpo.
May this right knowledge that you have given me render me with awakened awareness each and every moment. First, there is conviction or pratiti. Then it progresses further. So one comes into jnana. And if there is jnana, then experience arises. So we are saying that this knowledge of yours, that you have given me, may it give me awakened awareness or jagruti. Give me constant awakened awareness each and every moment. Then it says, sthul sanyogo, sukshma sanyogo, ane vanina sanyogo. Gross circumstances, subtle circumstances, and circumstances of speech. Subtle circumstances refers to thoughts that arise in the mind, the intents of the intellect, the ego. All the intents that tend to anoint or lepayaman bhavo, they are all subtle circumstances. And gross refers to all that you encounter through the body. Tea, snacks, meals, wife, children, office, they are considered gross circumstances. Then, if in your mind you think this work is boring, then those are subtle circumstances that arise in the mind. I want to eat a lot today, then I will go off to sleep peacefully. These are all subtle circumstances. Circumstances of speech, where words are uttered, those are all circumstances of speech. All of that belongs to the non-self or par and is subject to another entity or paradhin. Par means it falls under the part of the non-self and is subject to scientific circumstantial evidence or vyavasthit. Paradhin means it is subject to scientific circumstantial evidence. E jnan mara hridayne vishe sansthapit raho, sansthapit raho, sansthapit raho. Let that knowledge remain established in my heart. Heart meaning that it remains in my understanding. May it fit within me. May it heartily take hold in me. May that vision become still, become established. So it is saying, may the awakened awareness prevail for me. So it is saying, give me the energy not to interfere in any gross circumstances, subtle circumstances, or circumstances of speech. If interference occurs within, that I want to eat more, even then you have to see what he is doing. And after a while, he will say, I am full. So then he will stop. So you just have to keep seeing the pudgal or non-self complex. As to what subtle circumstances are arising, then what results arise, something negative heard by the ears, something positive heard, the disturbance that happens within, just keep seeing all of that. I will do this and I will do that. I'll sort them out. Why are you creating interference or dukkho like this? When we interfere or do dukkho, there will be corresponding reactions or dukkhal. What is dukkho? When a bullock is walking along, the herdsman pokes it with a stick. So the bullock thinks, he must be telling me to stop, so it stops. If your son is working nicely, but you tell him, you're not collecting the debts properly, you're not taking care of the business properly. Hey, but he's doing it properly. Let him carry on. Because you created interference or dukkho, its resultant reactions or dukkhal will ensue. He will think, my father's nature itself is to nag a lot. When interference or dukkho occurs, its resultant reactions or dukkhalo begin. So it says, dukkho dukkhal karu nahi tevi shakti apo. Grant me the energy not to interfere in whatever is happening. These examples are about interference on the outside. But we are not to interfere even with our own pudgal or non-self complex. If you feel from within that I want to go, but then you say, I don't want to go, then that is interference on our part. Just wait and see what this pudgal or non-self complex does. This top is spinning as per scientific circumstantial evidence or vyavasthit. It has already been wound up and now it is simply spinning. To keep seeing the spinning top is immense spiritual effort or purushartha. That is why it says, may I not interfere not subtly, not overtly, and not in speech. May I not interfere with anyone. May this knowledge remain established in my heart. Grant me the energy not to interfere in whatever is happening. And, keval dekhbhal karvani mane shakti apo. Grant me the energy to remain only the knower and the seer. In simple terms, in the colloquial language, it is called Dekhbhal. And in spiritual terms, it is called Gnata Drashta or Knower Seer. May I continue to see and know or Dekhu and Bhalu, Jo ane Janya Karu, and not grumble and gripe. So it says, grant me the energy to remain only the knower and the seer. Then it says, Keval ek apnij krupa no abhilashi chu. I am desirous of only your grace. What is krupa? There are three very nice words, krupa, Rajipo and Karuna. So when will you attain the Gnani's Rajipo, or to please the Gnani? When you keep abiding by the Gnani's Agnyas or directives. When you do as the Gnani says, that pleases the Gnani. And when that Rajipo accumulates, when we have 100 coins, we call it a rupee, don't we? In the same way, as it continues to accumulate, it becomes krupa or grace. So when you obtain 1 rupee, it is the equivalent of grace or krupa. 10 rupees is the equivalent of 10 krupa or grace. And when the krupa accumulates to 100, it is called karuna or compassion. And for the one who has acquired the Gnani's karuna, nothing remains thereafter. It begins from this. As you abide by the agnas, and even in that, there's only the nischay or firm resolve to abide by the agnas. You just have to remain sincere. There should be no insincerity or pole. That is where it begins. However much insincerity there is, that much Rajipo goes away. When Rajipo goes away, Krupa or grace stops. So then, how can you progress? So it should always be in our awareness. Will Dada be pleased with me if I do this? He will not. So this is a mistake of mine. If you turn back, then he will begin to be pleased. Start washing off your mistakes. When you make the firm resolve or nischay to remain in the 5 agnas, then he will be pleased. As he becomes pleased, you begin to become worthy of his krupa or grace. Then as you continue to be worthy of his grace, you attain karuna or compassion. Then that is considered completion or purnahuti. Apna charanarvind mara hridayama sthan paamu. Let your divine feet take a permanent place in my heart. The gross meaning of charanarvind is feet. It means that may I continue to behold you. May I hold you in my heart. May I constantly keep remembering you. This is the meaning at a gross level. And the subtle meaning is that charan means charya, which means acharan. Acharan means charitra or conduct. So may I acquire your conduct. The conduct that prevails for you, may my conduct be the same. That is the subtlest or sukshmatam meaning. And then the middle part refers to the charan or feet. Charan is also a very precious word. It means that liberation happens only at the charan or feet of the Gnani. The Gnani's charan is the solution to dissolve the ego. So as we continue to behold only the charan of the Gnani, the ego will begin to diminish. And when it goes from charan or feet into conduct or charya, then completion is attained. So it is saying, let your divine feet take a permanent place in my heart. May I behold your conduct or charitra in my heart, and have the expressed intent or bhavana accordingly, that may it be like this for me. May this prevail for me. But when his conduct is seen, it will begin in us as well. That is the rule. When it has begun to take hold, such as, Dada used to remain in such a wonderful equanimity, if that statement takes hold within, then that property or guna will manifest within you. That is how beautiful it is. So examine it, behold it. So then the results will continue to arise. Then it says,